Brad, what has this experience taught you about your team, about yourself?
Obviously it's been a when you say this experience, what are you referring to, John?
Oh, hold on, let me unmute him real quick. All right, go ahead, John.
The whole bubble, are you talking about the last?
I'm talking about the past few days, most more specifically.
Yeah, I mean, as we said a couple of days ago, I didn't know necessarily where the, what everyone would decide, that we were going to be fully supportive. I wasn't in every meeting, but I was in a couple, and a great deal of respect for the thoughtfulness of everyone involved. Obviously, it's a heavy time. It's been a heavy time, and I think everybody's decision to take a pause to reflect and to kind of focus on again what's most important, I thought was really well done, and showed another great leadership ability from several different groups in this league.
Question in person, Mark Medina.
Brad, the point you made that you were in on some of the meetings, how did you approach that overall in terms of offering any perspective on your own versus deferring to other
voices? I'm there mostly as a listener. I made myself available to our guys if they need anything from me, but it's there to support in any way that I can.
Abby Chin.
Brad, you've said it before, but can you speak to how proud you are to be associated with a league like this, and just how the NBA has been at the forefront in other sports and everything else has kind of taken notice and taken a note from you guys?
Yeah, I just think there's a lot of amazing people. Again, I think the player leadership has been great. And again, on down the line, it's just, it's a special group to be a part of. The Celtics are a special organization to be a part of. And the NBA as a whole, you certainly feel like it is. When everybody was talking about making sure that, this whole bubble experience was not just about basketball, but about bigger things and about inspiring and empowering. And I think, people have taken that very seriously and taken their role in that very seriously. Again, never probably more obvious than this week, with all that's going on.
Question in person, Gary Washburn.
Some players have referred to like Jacob Blake incident as kind of a point. And also this overall fatigue, these guys feel trapped. Some of these guys are feeling trapped here. Paul George said he was in a dark place because he wasn't playing well. Have you touched on that with the mental health aspect with your guys?
Yeah, so first of all, I think that's certainly there's a connection, but they're two different things, right? And I think they, to everybody's credit, I thought in all of the meetings, and Jalen has been vocal about this, like, we need to make sure that we're, everybody is fatigued in a lot of ways. And at the same time, we need to make sure that, coming back and playing is a great opportunity to use our voices and make sure this conversation is elevated and continues. But from a mental health standpoint in the bubble, listen, that's real. The bottom line is, it's hard to put much stock into, thoughts in the league if they're not here. I just think right now we have, we've been here 50 some odd days, and everybody obviously is coming off a very heavy week. But there have been plenty of days that have been difficult for people all across the board. We also, at the same time, Gary, we want to recognize how lucky we are to have a job and have an opportunity to do that job, right? So, like, we totally are conscious of all that's going on at that. But, listen, I see you every day, too, walking around. And, when you can't go by the fence, it is a unique setup. And so I think that, again, it is very unique. And you hear a couple of the teams that are already gone talk about that. But at the same time, the best part of the day for me, and I think for all of us, is when we're all together. And so that's on the court or in the meeting room, getting a chance to compete against a great team like Toronto tomorrow. And so that's, you know, been a lot of fun. And the opportunity to continue to use the platform the right way, I think, is those are the two things that keep you forward focused.
Gerard Blakely.
Yeah, Brad, one of the byproducts of the talks between the players and the NBA as a whole was this reinforced commitment to civic engagement and things of that nature based on a statement. And I'm just curious, Brad, from coaching perspective, what can the coaches, not you specifically, but just coaches in general, do beyond what you've done as far as supporting players and things along those lines?
Yeah, so I mean, first of all, the obvious things that came out of that meeting with the voting initiatives, you know, the PSAs, you know, making sure the focus continues to be on, you know, police accountability. I think all those things are clearly going to be emphases. Every team has taken to its own initiatives in its own locale. And I know for us, you know, we've created a huge plan of attack with every member of our organization where we can be even more focused on allocating our time, resources, and energy in several different areas, you know, whether it's voting, education, health, you know, again, you know, criminal justice, whatever the case may be, like everybody's working on that in their own locales and doing so in a way that I think is, you know, people are trying to figure out how best they can help. And we're no different than that. I feel really good about what the Celtics are doing and what they're putting together. The amount of work that Allison Feaster and others have put into this, Dave Hoffman, to get ready to, you know, do our part at a better level, I think is really important. So these initiatives that came out of that meeting, I think are important. I think they're, you know, obvious things that will be areas of focus and areas of attention, but that's not it. Like there's so much going on with all the teams in their own locales, with all the coaches and everybody else, that I think we all want to make a difference and we all want to make sure that we're, you know, part of the solution.
Mark Murphy.
Hey, Brad. Many players obviously were reluctant to come back. I'm sure they still have a lot of questions. Some of them might be divided. As coaches, what do you do about that?
When you say come back, what do you mean?
Come back to competition, return to play.
Well, I didn't hear that much with our team. You know, I said that before, like there hasn't been a lot of talk of that I've heard. Now that might not be the case. Everybody's dealing with this in their own way, but we have an open door and we've had a lot of great conversations, both individually and collectively. So, you know, we're going to do our very best to, you know, compete at our very highest level together. We have an incredibly tough task starting tomorrow at 1:00, and we know that.
Final question for Coach Adam Himmelsbach. All right, we will go to Mark D'Amico.
Hey, Coach. I know that this is, you know, the least important thing we'll talk about today, but Nick Nurse just spoke about how it took about half or three quarters of their practice to kind of reconcentrate on the task at hand, and that's playing basketball. Can you just speak to the challenge of you guys kind of recentering mentally to get back into the game that you're playing?
Yeah, that makes me feel better because we were about the same way, Mark. So I think that's just part of it. Listen, this has been mentioned on several occasions and you feel it. When I say the word heavy, it just means that everybody's human. Everybody is, you've seen a number of players speak this week. You've seen a number of others speak this week. There's a lot of emotions involved. And again, maybe what Gary said with the standpoint of you're also in this bubble and you're also isolated from your families and everything else, maybe that all plays a big role. I think ultimately there's a recognition amongst us all that are in the gym when we're going through practice that there is that element. And at the same time, we recognize that we are all held to, you know, playing well. And so that is a challenge. There's no question about it. I give huge kudos to the players on this team and all across the league that are here and that have, you know, had these, this level of discussion and this level of thought and put their heads together and decided to come back and play. But that's not going to mean that you just walk back on the court and you're excited about doing shell drill. You know, it's not the way it works, right? So ultimately, I think we all understand that. We're going to do our very best to be prepared for tomorrow, as is every other team. And when the ball gets tipped off, it'll hopefully be fun to watch.
All right, Coach, one last question. We're going to go back to Adam.
Okay.
Can you hear me, Brad?
I can hear you, Adam.
Yeah, I'm not sure why the first time it never worked.
They muted you on purpose.
Yeah, that could be. kind of playing off that, I mean, it's been a week now since you guys have played. Where do you feel like guys are at both mentally and physically to kind of – this isn't coming back for a scrimmage to get your legs under you. It's the Eastern Conference semifinals.
Yeah, physically we're fine. I mean, a week doesn't really matter. I mean, as far as, like, these guys are in top physical condition. They've shown that really all the way through the last few weeks. You know, I told you all along we were building up to August 17th. So these guys have had enough. We've had three or four times we've met as a team since we last played. And so there's been a physical element to each of those meetings. You know, they're going to be ready to play at a high level physically. And then mentally, it's just what I just said. It's not like you can just turn the switch off of your emotions and how you feel when you walk into the gym. The gym does provide a sanctuary to kind of get back to what you love and be together and do the thing that you've always loved to do since you were a kid. So eventually you do get to the point where I think when you're in it, the longer you're in it, the better. But that's just part of it. And, you know, the last thing that we're going to do is not recognize that everybody's, you know, dealing with that. And we're going to make sure that we're going to, again, do our best to be mentally, physically, emotionally, and everything else ready to go at our best level tomorrow.
All right. Thanks, Coach.
Thanks.